Okay, let's read it. 8 pieces of paper are numbered from 1 to 8 and placed in a box. 1 piece of paper is drawn from the box, its number written down, and the piece of paper is then replaced in the box. Then a second piece of paper is drawn from the box and its number is written down. Finally, the two numbers are added together. How many different ways can the sum of 12 be attained? All right, so let's see. We got, so the biggest number is 8, right? Whoa. Okay, so what do we have to add to get 12 there? Yeah, 4. Okay, what's the next number is 7. What would we have to add to it? 5, okay. The next number would be 6. What would we have to add? 6. Next number is 5. What would we have to add to that? 7. Next number is 4, and then it would be 8. And then 3, but then we can't use 9, right? So these are the only ways that we can add to get 12. So how many total is that? Yeah, it's because the piece of paper is replaced. It is put back, and so the 6 can technically be drawn twice.
No, I'm talking about the 7 and the 5. Like, you can
switch them. The 7. Oh yeah, switch them because it's the order. Oh, I see what you said, because you said order doesn't matter. Oh, I see what you said. Okay, no, this doesn't say anything like how many unique ways. If it said unique or different.
No, I gotta investigate.
Does it say different? Okay, it has to say unique. Good catch. Here we have the same problem, except it says, what does it say? 2 pieces of paper are drawn from the box at the same time. So this is almost like without replacement. Okay, and the number of pieces of paper are written down in total. How many different ways can number be obtained? Okay, so 2 can be written down, or like 2 can be drawn at the same time. So let's see, that means 8 and 4 would still be good, right? And so would 7 and 5. 6, nope, that one doesn't work anymore because there's not another 6. And then what about 5, 7? Can that be done? Yeah, so the order this time can be switched. So it looks like we only lost 1 total time. So there's 4 total.